Lord, praise the Lord with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at
the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed
wanted to be able to do, though, is during communion, I wanted to maybe go up to the crucifix. Can you make it, not right now, but at communion, I was going to try to do it. How do you make it go higher?
You just got to loosen it
up. Oh, you got to loosen it up. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Thank
it's
you.
It's live right now.
The morning will go synagogue and stop all have a parish. be faithful and say verses 1, 3, and 4. Number 3, 2, 1.
Pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
O God, who are pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house, the life one day eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Sirach. God sets a father in honor over his children. A mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Whoever honors his father atones for sins and preserves himself from them. When he prays, he is heard. He stores up riches who reveres his mother. Whoever honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays, is heard. Whoever reveres his father will live a long life. He who obeys his father brings comfort to his mother. My son, take care of your father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives. Even if his mind fail, be considerate of him. Revile him not all the days of his life. Kindness to a father will not be be forgotten, firmly planted against the debt of your sins, a house raised in justice to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways, for you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home, your children like olive plants around your table.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bearing with one another and forgiving one another, if one has a grievance against another. As the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love. That is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, be subordinate to your husbands, as is proper in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives, and avoid any bitterness toward them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is pleasing to the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children, so they may not become discouraged. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When the days were completed for their purification according to the law of Moses, they took Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, just as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer the sacrifice a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate in the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death until he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came in the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the custom of the law in regard to him, he took him into his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in sight of all the peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and the glory for your people, Israel." The children's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him, and Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and the rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and you yourself, a sword will pierce, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." There was also a prophetess Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 7 years with her husband after her marriage, and then as a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very hour, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Beloved, as we continue to glory in the birth of our Savior, we recognize that his becoming one of us was the most wonderful act of compassion ever known in the history of the world, that he should become one of us. He did so, as you all know, to save us. But in so doing, God became man, come to understand us. And in understanding us completely, our human condition, our situation, our weakness, and our frailty, our blessed Lord is able, in understanding us, to show us compassion. And so, to remind you, beloved, the word compassion comes from two Latin words, cum passio, which means to suffer with. And so I would like to offer you a reflection on the word compassion, because compassion becomes the hallmark or the key to family life. I'll give you three examples to help you to understand compassion, or understanding another person's situation. By the way, as an aside, I give my homilies to other priests, and they say, "You make up your stories, don't you?" It comes to God too, because I don't. The three examples I'm going to give you are real. A few years back, I was traveling with a couple in a car. The man was driving, the wife was in the passenger seat, I was in the back seat. We were traveling south on Highway 59, going to dinner, I believe to a restaurant either in Gulf Shores or near there. Anyhow, it was a Friday afternoon, and somewhere down County Road, around County Road 12, County Road 10, a man in a big truck pulled out right in front of us. He was pulling a trailer, and the man who was driving our parishioner had to apply his brakes very strongly. And and the man exclaimed from the driver's seat, "That man must be crazy." And his wife said, "Honey, he's not crazy. It's Friday afternoon and he just wants to get home." Second, we have I have a very good friend who's principal of a high school. And her teachers come into her office often, and they explain to her the difficulties of their children. I'm sure none of you can relate to that. So the lady, who's a brilliant person, said, "Listen," to a teacher, she tells them often, "Don't just look at how they're behaving in the classroom. Rather, try to understand what they bring to school from their home." Third, comes from something personal. I'm very blessed to have two volumes of letters that my mother wrote to me. Great treasure. I guess I'll have to be buried with them because nobody's going to want them. Anyhow, the first letter in the first volume is a letter she wrote to me when I was 18. I turned to it often. She put me right in my place. She never gave it to me. She wrote it and she put it away. I found it in a cedar chest when she died. She wrote this when I was 18. I read it and I had just been ordained. She said, "You think you're a good Catholic." She said, "You are not." She said, "Your father is confined to a wheelchair, and all he wants to do is spend time with his youngest child. And you're always too busy. And when you're with him, you don't respect him. You should have compassion for your father." The Son of God became man. He has compassion on us. Husbands, don't ask why your wife, why she did what she did. Try to understand her feelings. Wives, don't say he's a no good rotten. Now, he might be no good and rotten, but try to understand why he's no good and rotten. Try to understand why he feels the way he feels. Parents, you remember when you wanted independence, don't you? Help yourself with God's grace to understand why your children are behaving the way they are. Children, understand your parents have the responsibility for your soul, your body, your mind, and your whole self, and that they look out for your good. And if you don't get what you want, it's because they love you. Compassion, to put on Christ, is to be his presence in family. And when we are compassionate and show compassion to those who are in our families become holy because we are shedding the light of Jesus upon the family. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come.
Amen. Amen.
trust and confidence we offer these petitions.
For all who serve in the church, may their ministry continue to be a sign of God's love for all people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may God's love penetrate the hearts of all people, bringing them peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all abandoned or abused children, may caring families provide homes where God's love resides. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the families of our parish, may the intercession of the Holy Family bring them many blessings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who grieve the loss of loved ones, may the promise of eternal life with the Lord bring them comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all first responders and members of the military to be protected by God's mighty hand. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We offer to the Lord our own prayers and moments of silence. Dear Father, hear the prayers we offer for the intercession of Saint Joseph, the most chaste spouse of the glorious Virgin Mary, in the name of Jesus, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Exist in time, so that
raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to his heavenly kingdom. And so, with all the angels and saints, we cry out the hymn of your joy, your hymn of your glory, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Jesus Christ.
Go with him and in him.
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord, in Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer each other a sign of peace.
Please join the singing at number 217, Once We Were a Great City.
Thank you.
to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Welcome, visitors to St. Margaret's this morning. We're glad you've come to be with us for Mass. If you've moved to the area or have been coming a while, to the parish, please join our parish. There are membership forms and vestibule. Take them up, fill it out, and put it in the collection. Or you can join our parish online at our website. I would like for every family to take a copy of the bulletin home after this Mass. The family in the vestibule, this is the best one I've ever done. you really wouldn't know how much work goes into just the front cover. I haven't even do it. This is the Nativity in our church, and it's just so beautiful. It's like a keepsake, this bulletin. So please take it home. I'd like to point out to you, beloved, that it's Happy Mother's Day this week. It's a holy day. January 1st is always a holy day to honor Mary, the Mother of God, because you can't have a nativity without a mother. So we take the 1st of January, it's always holy when we come to Mass. So the holy day Mass schedule is this. On Thursday, New Year's Eve, the holy day Mass for New Year's Day is at 5:30. On New Year's Day, the Mass is at 9 a.m. Please come to honor our dear mother, Jesus' mother Mary, on that day. Also, if you recall the mission, the movie Mission Impossible, I have a mission. Should you like, should you wish to receive it, I'll accept it.
There you go.
Okay, I want to invite you and beg you to adore the Blessed Sacrament all day on the 31st of December this week for two reasons. And so you sign up at the end of Mass and you'll be able to meet or come. Two reasons. That the Lord will see fit to spare us of the pandemic in the coming year. That's the first petition. First petition, the Lord will spare us of the pandemic in the coming year. The second is that all Roman Catholics who have fallen away from the practice of the faith because of the pandemic would come back. Let me explain something to you. There are some things only that God accomplishes through our prayer and fasting. We count everyone in church in October. It's just the custom of the Archdiocese. Just at this Mass alone, only at the 10:30 Mass, there are an average of over 200 people who are not coming to this Mass alone. So I'm begging you to come to enjoy the Blessed Sacrament, because hundreds of people are coming to our parish alone. We multiply that times 75 parishes in the Archdiocese, and multiply that by all the dioceses in the country, and multiply that by all the countries in the world. And you have millions of Catholics who have not received the Eucharist in over a year and are not practicing their faith. So I want you to come on New Year's Eve to go to the Blessed Sacrament from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., please. Also, dear ones, remember that Christmas is not a day. For us, it's a season. As I can give you an example, we were decorating the church. I wasn't decorating the church for Christmas, but I was with people who were. And so anyhow, this lady walked in the vestibule, a precious lady, goes to another church, not the Catholic Church. And she called me, came to tell me that one of